Yes, Father, we just give in to your love. We thank you, God, that there's nothing that cannot be overcome by your love that triumphs over us, over our fears, over our insecurities, over everything that holds us back. We thank you, God, that we find ourselves in a safe place as we surrender unto you. We thank you, Father. We trust in you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. This morning we'll actually be going into an intercessory time. The past month we've been singing and meditating through Isaiah 60. And this morning we will be praying these verses over the nation of Israel. So if you have your Bibles with you, I encourage you to open up to Isaiah chapter 60, verses 1 through 9. And as we go through these verses, we encourage you to take up your authority and proclaim and declare these verses over the nation of Israel. We'll begin with Isaiah chapter 60, verses 1 through 3. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples. But the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Nations will come to your light, and kings the brightness of your dawn. Father, we thank you for the unrelenting fulfillment of your promises over Israel. Even through seasons of darkness, exile, persecution, and a continual turning away, your promise of the Jesus, the Messiah, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Savior that has come, and the eternal King that is to return, has been fulfilled through Israel. Jesus Christ, you are the Word become flesh and the light of the world. Unhindered by darkness, unrestrained by death, you are the glory and the image of the Father, the victor and the bridegroom who is to return for his bride and the nations. Arise, O Israel, your light has come. Your salvation has come. Arise, O Israel, to your destiny as a light unto the nations of the earth. Arise from the scourge, arise from the shame, arise from the darkness, for the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. The night is past, the dawn is upon us. Arise, O Israel, into the glory of the Lord. risk. Verses 4 through 5. Lift up your eyes and look about you. All assemble and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters are carried on the hip. Then you will look and be radiant. Your heart will throb and swell with joy. The wealth of the seas will be brought to you. To you, the riches of the nations will come. Father, we declare that a new season has come, no longer downcast. Israel will lift up her eyes and see the blessings of God surround and engulf her. Her sons and daughters coming from afar, the radiance of the Lord will be upon her face. The joy of the Lord will swell within her heart, and the provision of the nations will overflow her cup. This is a season of hope. It is a time of her rising. All the scattered will return. All that has been lost will be restituted. Israel shall no longer be a deserted nation, but one covered in the favor and extravagant blessing of the King, brimming over with life, strengthened in the place of hope. Lift up your eyes, Israel, and behold the blessings of the Lord come upon you.
Even now the Lord is sending.
favor of the Lord is upon you. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 6 and 7. Herds of camels will cover your land, young camels of Midian and Ephah, and all from Sheba will come, bearing gold and incense and proclaiming the praise of the Lord. All Kedar's flocks will be gathered to you. The rams of Nebaioth will serve you. They will be accepted as offerings on my altar, and I will adorn my glorious temple. Father, it is your desire to see your dwelling place made ready here on earth. Through supernatural provision and blessing, you will adorn your glorious temple. You will prepare for yourself a temple not made by human hands, but by yours. All those you gather to yourself will praise your holy name as a sound of worship fills the land. You alone will be exalted as a nation's gathered to your light and stand in awe of your glory. We long to see the day you receive the praises of every tribe and tongue, and we eagerly await the day we will see the coming to you in worship and adoration.
Oh,
Isaiah 60, verses 8 and 9. Who are these that fly along like clouds, like doves to their nests? Surely the islands look to me, and the lead are the ships of Tarshish, bringing your children from afar with their silver and gold to the honor of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has endowed you with splendor. Father, all is to the honor of the Holy One of Israel, the God of glory, the Ancient of Days, the Alpha and the Omega. We declare that Israel will be endowed and crowned with splendor, that the healing and restoration of Israel will be unto your glory. We believe that even as your children draw near and riches overflow in your land, the greatest splendor you will bestow on this land is your very presence. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, you are goodness and glory and beauty. Your presence is life. Your judgments are righteous. You are our reward and our portion forever. May Israel delight and rejoice in you as you fill her with your glory. Look up and see your glory rising. They will taste and see. Arise, O Israel. For your light has come. The glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Thank you. Father, we tap into your heart for your people and your nation. Even in our limited understanding, even in our limited compassion, we thank you, Father, that as we go deeper into your heart, you show us what your affections, your longings, your promises, your desires for your people in Israel are. We thank you, God, and we come into agreement with the words that you have spoken through Isaiah 60. We call forth Israel to arise and shine, for her light has come and the glory of the Lord has risen upon her. We thank you, Father, that your intentions for your people, Lord God, have never changed, that your heart still burns for your people in Israel, that you will have your way, that everything that you have started, you will finish unto completion. We thank you, God, that every promise in you is yes and amen, and that your grip and your hold, your faithfulness over Israel has not diminished from generation to generation. We will see your promises come to pass. We will see the goodness of the Lord rising upon your people. We take confidence and we take rest in knowing, Father, that you are already moving in your people in Israel. And we thank you, Father, that you bring us into the place of intercession to come into agreement with your promises, your heart for your people. We thank you, Father. We love you. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Your spirit strong in me, my flesh may fail. strong in me, my flesh may fail, my God, you never will. Oh, you never fail.
At this time, we're going to transition into a time of intercession on behalf of Israel. We'll be showing a few prayer points on the screen and encourage you, as I lead out in prayer, to come into agreement and follow up my intercession with your own prayers. Father, we pray for your people to be provoked with jealousy unto repentance. God, how unsearchable are your ways. How great is your mercy that you would harden the hearts of Israel for the sake of the salvation of the Gentiles. Until the fullness of the Gentiles come in, we will continue to pray for the softening of the hearts of Israel, that they would not be left out from this plan of salvation, but that instead they would be provoked to jealousy as they see the Gentiles enjoy the free gift of grace. We pray for a divine softening of their hearts as you orchestrate divine encounters through the Word, through dreams and visions, and through supernatural visitations. Father, we pray that it wouldn't stop at that, but that the fruit of your stirring in their hearts would be conviction and true repentance, a rending of their hearts instead of their garments, as they put their trust in you once again. Let's pray.
Thank you.
secondly, we will pray for a return in humility unto the Lord for the people of Israel. Father, we admit that our hearts are prone to pride and self-reliance, that outside of your grace and your mercy, there is no hope for our healing. We pray that as you soften our hearts to hear the voice of the Good Shepherd, to hear the voice of the Bridegroom, would you initiate in their hearts not just a response of stubbornness, but that of humility, that you'd bring us to a place of confessing that we are unable to save ourselves outside of what you've done on our behalf through the cross of Jesus Christ. We pray for a turning from idolatry, that the names of Baal will be stripped away from the lips of your bride, that Israel would come out of the wilderness leaning not on her ability, but leaning on her beloved. May your forgiveness and your healing be the hope of glory for Israel. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Next, we will pray for hope and restoration. Father, you proclaim to your people through the first coming of Jesus, the Messiah, here is your God. Behold, he is Emmanuel, God with us. He has not forgotten you, O Israel. We come against an orphan spirit in Israel as you remind her that you have not forsaken her, that her walls are ever before you, and you have engraved her name in the palms of your hands. We break up hopelessness regarding God's promises yet to be fulfilled, and we call forth faith and hope to arise in Israel in this season. Raise up messengers that will be your mouthpieces, men and women of God who prepare the way of the return of the Lord as they preach the message of the Messiah through their land, saying, lift up your eyes, O Israel, have hope once again. Here is the Messiah. Here is your God. Here is your God. Let's pray. Lastly, we will pray for fulfillment in glory over Israel. Father, you have created Jerusalem not to be a cursed city, but for her to be a joy, and that her people would be gladness unto you and unto the nations. We rejoice in Jerusalem, delight over your people. You will trade in her all, you will trade in all her ashes for joy, her mourning for garments of praise. You are true to your promise that she will be multiplied unto you, that she will possess the lands you have set apart for her, and she shall be a blessing to all the nations of the earth. Your people were made to be a blessing. Before the beginning of time, you ordained Israel to be a light that cannot be hidden, filled with your glory, covered with your presence, empowered through your Holy Spirit. God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, have your way with her. Have your way with Israel and fulfill every promise you have spoken. Let's pray. God, we thank you for your people. We trust in your work. We have faith in your unrelenting promises that every word that you've spoken will not return to you empty. Father, you are good and all the works of your hands are good. Draw your beloved Israel to you once again. May her testimony of healing and restoration be one that brings you great glory among the nations. May her newfound love and devotion to you be an inspiration to all the nations. We thank you, Father, that your hand is upon your people in Israel, that your promises will not return to you empty. We thank you, Father, that all these things you're fulfilling in your time, according to your perfect plan. We have trust and confidence, Father, that your commitment to your people in Israel continues to this day and will move onward, Lord God, unto eternity. We thank you, God, for all these things. We trust in you. We love you, God. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you for joining us this morning. We invite you to come out as well tomorrow.